I can't say that, you know, you play for 10 years and X happens, or you are going to have this or that. To me, it's like jumping into the water and you can't see how deep it is. I don't know if I'm going to go through and be unscathed, or if I'll cut my foot, or if I'll land face first into a rock. You don't know. To me, that risk isn't worth it, and I've got enough going on in my life and other interests where that I want to pursue.
Chris Borland could hit hard, hard enough to play middle linebacker in the National Football League. That talent meant fame, financial success, and the realization of a dream. But after one season, he says his career is over. He considers the risk to his brain too great to make a living banging heads, and he's out. He says he isn't sending a message, but a message has been sent. How far will it reach? That's today's Outside the Lines.
And now, sitting in for Bob Lee, TJ Quinn.
It's impossible to know what Chris Borland gave up to get to the NFL if you measure it in terms of pain and sacrifice. He made it, and he played a season with the San Francisco 49ers. And now, at the age of 24, he's decided that the price he paid to get there and the money he could earn there aren't worth the risk to his health. Borland announced his retirement last night, telling Outside the Line Steve Fainru and Mark Fainru-Wada that after extensive research, he's too concerned about the risk of brain trauma. News about traumatic brain injury and its devastating effects have become commonplace, with the struggles of veterans like Jim McMahon and Tony Dorsett, and the suicides of players like Junior Seau and Dave Duerson. But the retirement of a successful 24-year-old is something new. Borland sat down with Mark Fainru-Wada just a little while ago.
Tell us why you decided to retire.
Well, I think it was a culmination of a number of things. It's a unique decision to me. I'd done a lot of research of what I had experienced in my past, projected to what I would have to do to be the linebacker I wanted to be, and for me it wasn't worth the risk. Not to say it's a certainty. I could be wrong. I hope I'm not. I hope I am wrong, honestly. But for me, it was the right decision.
When you thought about that risk, I mean, what did you, as you played it out in your mind, what were you imagining could happen to you?
Brain disease, frankly. And not to say that players who've played for a long time, who've been physical players, that it's a foregone conclusion. But to me, the chance of that happening was more of a negative than the positive that my potential career could be.
When did you begin to think about this?
I'd always been aware. I think when it changed from an awareness to actively researching and finding out more as it pertained to my life and my football career, I would say this past August.
So at the start of training camp, you're beginning to really start to, you hadn't even played a game yet.
Yeah, one instance in particular in camp where I thought I sustained probably a mild concussion and just played through what football players refer to as a ding or getting your bell rung. And that was the moment where it really went differently for me. It wasn't just in the periphery aware of things that are going on. It became more wanting to research and find out the seriousness of the issue.
What was it about that hit?
It was just kind of the realization, I just started my professional career, and am I going to go down this road? Am I going to commit the prime of my life to something that could ultimately be detrimental to my health? And that just kind of triggered my thinking and changed the way I viewed the risks.
What do you think the message is that people are going to get from you deciding to retire so soon?
I don't want the message to be absolutely don't play football or decide not to do this or that. I think the thing that I can convey to youth and to parents is just make an informed decision. If you weigh the risks and you decide, is this something you want to partake in? It's a free country, and the NFL, will exist for a long time. They make a lot of money, so you have the freedom to do what you want, and I think that's important. However, I would just, if I could relay a message to kids, to their parents, it'd be twofold. And one, just make an informed decision, and two, don't play through concussions.
You began to have this just incredible season for the Niners, one of the top rookies. Patrick Willis gets hurt. You're playing, two interceptions in a game, first time for a rookie Niner. Does that impact you as you're sort of thinking about what you're going to do?
It was kind of confusing. I mean, I don't think it swayed my decision. I think how I felt and what I had learned was more important than two interceptions in a game or accolades or team or even team success. Individual health is there's few things in the world more important than that.
One of the things Niners fans found solace in was that you were going to be here. I think it's such a hard thing for people to process. Can you sort of elaborate on that at all?
Yeah, I can relate. I mean, from the outside looking in, that it wouldn't make sense to a lot of people. And I've had close friends who said, well, why don't you just play one more year? It's a lot more money. You probably won't get hurt. I just don't want to get in a situation where I'm negotiating my health for money. And who knows how many hits is too many. And my end goal is a long-term picture. It's not, I'm not willing to sacrifice 15 to 20 years of my life, even if I die healthy, but younger. You know, I want to live a long, healthy life. And I could be wrong. I hope I am. I hope my friends and teammates who've played this game and continue to decide to play this game are healthy. But for me, just personally, I don't think the risks were worth what I could gain from football.
How widespread is the concern amongst players?
I do think it's more well understood right now in the 2015 NFL than it was 5, 10, 20 years ago. But it's not something that is openly talked about a whole lot. There's a task at hand, and it's very much a focused arena where it's just you're plotting forward and you're in this together. And that's been the most difficult part for me, is I loved being a teammate. I loved the camaraderie. And I just don't want to leave my guys hanging. And they were counting on me to be there next year. And they're great people and friends. So it's that hurts. But I know this is right for me.
Our reactions coming in from all over the NFL. Russell Wilson, who played with Chris Borland at the University of Wisconsin and against him in the NFL, had this to say. He said, pleasure playing with you, Chris Borland, UW Badgers, and against you for the 49ers, praying for you. Denver linebacker Brandon Marshall said, so Patrick Willis and Chris Borland, they know something we don't? Willis, of course, retired due to injuries 1 week ago. And from Seattle's Bobby Wagner, no offense to anyone, but I'm playing until I can't anymore. I love this game too much.